We'll be bringing you an interconference matchup in this one as the Spurs come into town. Happy holidays, everyone, from all of us at 2K Sports. And do we have a present for you today? With Greg Anthony and Brent Berry, this is Kevin Harlan. We'll be hearing from David Aldridge on the sideline. In the last meeting for these two teams, the Spurs came away with the win against the Knicks.
And really brought an impressive physicality to that matchup, drawing a ton of fouls, and of course, went on to win it.
No doubt, that's what made the difference. The aggression they showed, attacking, drawing contact, it got them points at the line and made foul trouble a big concern on the other side.
And before we get going, let's hear from David Aldridge on the sideline. David?
Well, guys, Kristaps Porzingis was taken with the fourth pick in 2015, and he was considered a project then. But he's shown himself ready, and part of that has been his mentality. He said, they thought I was afraid, but that's not who I am. I'll never back down from anybody. If I want to succeed, I can't be scared of anybody. I've got to be fearless out there on the court. Kevin?
Thanks, GA. And what's scary is Porzingis is only going to get better. That kind of fearlessness will help him in the long run. A lot of experienced veterans in tonight's game, which brings up a question, Brent. We often see freshmen dominate in college, but it usually takes years for someone to have that same domination in the pros. Why the difference?
I don't know, Kevin. You've been watching the last 4 or 5 years. Doesn't it feel like the young guys are coming in and doing damage right away?
I see them exactly. Their fingerprints have never been more bold and impactful than right now.
I agree. The last decade has shown some of the incredible talent and young talent that the league has been able to find, and they've come in and done a remarkable job with each of their opportunities.
All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. On the court for San Antonio, the defensive tandem of Green and Leonard outside. Aldridge is at the four with Gasol at the five. And it's Parker in at the one spot. The San Antonio Spurs able to put the first points up on the board. Lee against Green. No good from Lee. And San Antonio has possession. It's a three-point game. This game coming after a loss against the Pistons.
Just didn't like the energy level in that one, and that offensive execution also was lacking.
Well, they made a few shots, Reg, but just wildly inconsistent.
And the rejection by Leonard. Outside, Green. There's the dish to Leonard. Good-looking screen by Gasol. Leonard, the pass to Gasol. Excellent D from Cantor.
Well, from our angle, that looked like that was going in. But defense, fantastic how they contested it.
And Pau Gasol, one of the most skilled seven-footers this league has ever seen. Whether it's the low post, high post, flaring off picks, you want the ball in his hands.
Now here's Leonard. His last outing, he had 18 points. Really left alone that time. Gasol's got five.
That's something Pau has had most of his career, is that mid-range shot when he's got enough space, shoots it with rhythm and confidence, and you've got to respect his ability to score the ball from there.
Porzingis against Aldridge. Some nice passing by New York here. Five on the clock. Here's Cantor. San Antonio with the rebound. And Pau Gasol, a very good perimeter shooter, starting to stretch his range out beyond that three-point arc.
Yeah, his face-up game is becoming more and more prominent. Working from that elbow, he's become more of a triple threat. He can shoot it, drive it, and pass at a high level.
Count the basket.
It's an underrated strength of LaMarcus Aldridge, able to power in the shot even when being fouled.
Parker against Jack. Green by Porzingis. Lee kicks to Cantor. And Gasol sends it back.
Gasol did not stop moving his hands there, especially as the shot was going up. Always going to be right there to send anything back if it's close.
Now here's Parker. Looking in his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points a game. Gasol, a screen on Lee. Kicks it to Aldridge. Tipped away. Porzingis with the steal. Outside Jet. And there's the pass to Lee. There's a screen by Cantor. Lee dishes to Jet. And he uses the glass on the layup.
And Lee does a little bit of everything well for this ball club.
3-second difference between shot clock and game clock. Aldridge a screen. Back to Green. Takes a three. They get it back. Stolen by Kanter. Outside Thomas. Shoots over Leonard. What a play! Simply drains it in at the buzzer.
And they make sure to get the last shot of the quarter there. Nicely done.
And a good awareness there to beat the clock. Now they have a break in the action to discuss some other things.
One quarter in the books, and it's been a close one so far. It's the Knicks leading by a point. And the second quarter will be on the way when we come back. Neither team able to build much of a lead up to this point as we start the second quarter. The Knicks with the lead. And Brent, they're in a lot of places quite as special as playing here in New York and on this floor. What was it like for you the first time you played against the Knicks in New York?
Unbelievable. I love getting to the big city every year. Amazing to be inside the Garden. I have to tell you, Kevin, one of my favorite things was to walk to the New York Knicks opposing team locker room and see the poster of Frank Sinatra outside the locker room. He did it his way, and we ended up doing it ours.
On the floor for San Antonio, Mills and Manu at the guards. Aldridge out there with Rudy Gay, and it's Forbes in at the small forward position. Spurs trail by four. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Pass to Aldridge. He dishes it to Ginobili. No good on the three. New York's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. The feed to McDermott. At the top of the key, O'Quinn. It's rebounded by Aldridge. Aldridge has got four rebounds in this game. They set the screen. And Forbes kicks to Aldridge. It's Ginobili on the wing. That doesn't go either by Ginobili. The Knicks leading by four. Here's Ntilikina. And it's Gay with the rebound.
Yeah, bad shot there. Trust is lacking. You got to be willing to make the extra pass.
Yep, just too anxious to try and make something happen out there. This is about the team, not about you.
Mills can't hit. The Knicks have gotten only one of their first four shots in the second quarter to drop. McDermott, no one around him. New York, no good that time either. Spurs trail by four.
And LaMarcus Aldridge really possesses tremendous shooting touch when you consider this guy's basically a seven-footer, and he's increasing that range. Last season, up over 40% from three.
Here's O'Quinn. Hits the front of the rim and out. They've been hanging in there.
And a chance here to jump on top.
Ginobili kicks to Aldridge. Aldridge a screen. Here's Mills. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Forbes can't get it to go. And Aldridge doesn't shoot a ton of threes, yet he still earns his keep in that mid-range.
Yeah, on that left block, back to the basket. And with his size, that turnaround, Jay, is just about unstoppable.
And here's the break. To the left wing. Some nice passing by New York here. Picked by O'Quinn. McDermott kicks to O'Quinn. Just four to shoot. Stolen by Ginobili. Here is Forbes. He's coming off a 10-point game against Detroit. Here's the screen. Aldridge kicks to Ginobili. Six on the shot clock. Over O'Quinn. And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim. Ginobili's got 5 points in the quarter.
Undeterred with a hand in his face, Ginobili's been taking advantage of that kind of defense for a long time.
Beasley the screen. Some solid defense from Gay. And we're through the first half of basketball here in what's been a good one. Spurs lead by one. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks, Kevin. Kawhi, you have grown so much offensively throughout your career. What's the focus at that end of the floor?
Just knocking down open shots, my ball handling, and making good decisions off the pick and roll, and just try to limit my turnovers.
And you've done well so far, Kawhi. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, Dave, thank you. And time now for the halftime break, with the third quarter soon to follow, right here on 2K Sports.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, folks. Welcome back. Ernie Johnson here with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. This is the Halftime Show on 2K Sports. A pretty close game for the Spurs throughout the first quarter. They saw their lead grow to a high water mark of 5 in the period. The second quarter was a tight battle, but they were the slightly better team. Not by very much, however. Kenny, what was your take on San Antonio?
Well, I like their effort on the boards, because a game could come down to just a few key possessions, and extra rebounds can give you those extra possessions if you work at it.
Shaq, what did you think about New York?
Well, Ernie, this is definitely a big wake-up call for them. Their field goal percentage is sitting in the low 30s. They came out unfocused, unmotivated, unprepared. If they can't turn the tide and play with greater efficiency, it's going to be a long second half.
And that wraps up the halftime show. Third quarter set to begin in just a few.
Welcome back, everyone. The second half about to get underway, and it's been a close one so far. Pau Gasol with a strong contribution so far in this one.
And you know he's going to come out aggressive, and you do what you can to slow him down, and thus far it hadn't worked because he's been amazing.
Even though we expected.
Hey, Brent, what's more important, offense or defense? Some guys are great at both.
Well, offense is sometimes what you get paid for, Kevin, but defense is where you need a buy-in. And so to me, it's always the defense and the way that you construct that camaraderie on that end of the floor, that communication on that end of the floor, that's going to make the difference in your season.
Don't you love two-way players, though, guys that play hard at both ends? It's hard to do, but the guys that do it well really stand out.
Well, it's not football, Kevin. There's two sides that you have to play in basketball, and certainly the more equipped that you are to play both, the more playing time you're going to see for a coach.
Lee out there with Jarrett Jack. Then there's Lance Thomas. Then it's Enes Kanter. And it's Porzingis in at the power forward position. They're the group for Jeff Hornacek starting the second half. And Kawhi Leonard, the only player other than Michael Jordan and Hakeem Olajuwon to be an all-star starter. Greg win the Defensive Player of the Year and win a Finals MVP award.
And Kevin, I think it's fair to say that's some lofty company to be in. You're worried with the retirement of Tim Duncan. Would the Spurs go through a lull? And they found another two-way superstar to kind of build their team around, much in the same in terms of mannerisms as a Tim Duncan.
And he knocks down the first one. And the Spurs got Kawhi Leonard to be the next Bruce Bowen. But from his rookie season, I think Pop realized, Brent, he could be the face of the franchise.
Well, it's amazing that they had talked with that kind of regard for Kawhi Leonard after making the draft day trade and sending away George Hill. They felt like Kawhi Leonard could make that kind of progression. Now, I would also tell you that they had no idea he would become one of the more devastating players on the offensive end of the floor. But the work ethic was there, the size was there, and the fruits of the labor are paying off.
There's a screen by Kanter. And Thomas has it in the corner. New York, no good that time either.
They got to be more active on offense and maybe a little bit more aggressive going to the rim. 0 of 4, not impressive thus far.
Knicks trail by 3. Outside Jack. Terrific design on the pick play. He lays it in.
All right. After 4 misses, they finally get one to go. That has to be a big relief for the offense after beginning this half on a bit of a cold streak.
Gasol setting the pick for Parker. Aldridge, the pass to Leonard. He kicks to Gasol. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Gasol's got 7.
And Gasol is an accomplished scorer on the inside. Tall, long, crafty, smart. Should I go on?
Kanter dishes to Thomas. There's a screen by Kanter. Thomas, a screen on Leonard. Here's Porzingis, gets the bucket and the foul. It's on Kawhi Leonard. And Brent, you went up against Hornacek as a player and even defended him a couple times. What was it like playing against Hornacek, the player?
Well, I want you to ask Jeff Hornacek if I defended him, because I thought I did a good job, and sometimes the box score didn't reveal it. But what a tremendous shooter, a great off-ball mover, certainly in that system with John Stockton. And if there was any room, Kevin, that I gave Jeff Hornacek, and trust me, there was plenty of times I did that, he was knocking down jump shots. One of the most efficient players in Jazz history.
And it's tied up with that one.
Well, they love Porzingis and his talent, but on top of that, they like the fact that he thinks the game and he works at the game.
Outside, Green. Gasol kicks to Leonard for three. Good, and the assist goes to Gasol. He's got five.
And his versatility on offense is so spectacular. He always finds ways to help put points up on the board.
Jack passes to Porzingis. Thomas a screen. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Pretty clear that for the New York Knicks, the next best big thing in the city is Kristaps Porzingis. This franchise knows that he's the future and also the present. So he'll be the star that they build around in years to come.
First free throw is good. And for KP taking over as the best player on his team, Brent, he's probably earned it. Fantastic play from him, and he has far surpassed expectations.
Well, I think he showed some great signs last year. In his first year, his rookie campaign, he really struggled coming down the stretch. And I think whatever he did in the offseason to prepare himself for his sophomore year got him through the season much more consistently. But how lucky were the Knicks to get this guy? And we'll see if he ends up becoming the cornerstone of what they do in the future.
Dishes it to Gay. And Mills kicks to Leonard. And it's off from three-point range. Outside Jack for the lead. And Gasol sends it back.
Yeah, this is a terrible start for him, and it has to be weighing on him.
Stolen by Cantor. And here is Jack. And looking at his production, he averages a little more than 7 points a game. Pass to Ntilikina. And the Knicks miss again. San Antonio leading. Here's Leonard. Shot goes down. Very quick possession right there. Leonard's got 7 points.
Yeah, this is a tough one. The D is giving up way too many open looks, guys, and they're paying for it.
Just 2 seconds between shot clock and game clock. There's a screen by Cantor. Outside, Porzingis. Five to shoot. Over Gay. Sinks it. And the shot from Porzingis. He has 7.
Porzingis able to score on all 3 levels. Defensively, you just can't leave that guy alone.
And we just finished the 3rd quarter, and we've got a tight ball game here. It's San Antonio leading by a point. And time to step aside quickly, but we'll be back in no time with the start of the 4th quarter. A chance now to hear Greg Popovich talking to his team just moments ago.
But don't stop the aggressiveness. You got shots, let them fly.
And that's the thing about Greg Popovich. As long as you're taking good shots, he doesn't want you to hesitate. Doesn't want you to stop.
Well, and the offense is designed to create opportunities. So if you pass up the opportunity, you're kind of defeating the whole purpose of the exercise.
All right, we welcome you back to what's been a hard-fought battle. 4th quarter should be good. On the court right now for the Spurs, Leonard and Gay are the forward pair. Mills and Manu at the guards. And it's Gasol at the center position.
The defense, not so good. And when you're deep inside like that, you got to come through.
Ginobili dishes to Mills. Ginobili left side. Gasol kicks to Leonard. Gasol a screen. And Leonard gets it to go. Leonard's got the first basket as we get going in the fourth for San Antonio. Picked by O'Quinn. Here's Ntilikina. And Gasol sends it back. An even 3-on-3 break. And Ginobili wide open. He shoots. Gets the three-pointer to fall.
And offensively, they seem to have turned a corner.
New York calls timeout.
Yeah, it looks like they tried to shoot their way out of the slump, and that didn't work. They got to go back and regroup.
Well, no matter how hard it's been, you want to stay positive, stay focused, and maybe a couple shots will get you right back in it.
Looking at who's out there now for the Spurs. LaMarcus Aldridge just checked in for Gabe. Green comes in for Manu Ginobili. And Parker subbed in for Patty Mills. He gets a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, he was able to listen in on what Jeff Hornacek said to his team. He told them, it's time for you to fight to get this lead. Let's bring this one home. Guys, we'll see if they have what it takes to get it done. Back to you.
There's a screen by Cantor. And here's Porzingis for a three. It's hauled in by Tony Parker. Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. He feeds it to Green. Pass to Leonard. Good, and it's Green picking up the assist. And it's a 10-point Spurs lead.
And there just aren't many guys that have a more devastating mid-range game. Leonard has fine-tuned that shot to where it's almost automatic.
And here's Porzingis for a three. New York, no good that time either.
And you know what? You can't get a better screen. Frees him up beautifully, but he just fails to capitalize.
Oh, man, he'd love to have that one back. He just does everything right, but doesn't get the finish.
And that one's good. Parker.
And when you give Parker room to work his magic down inside, he knows how to finish with style.
Cantor with a screen on Parker. There's a screen by Cantor. Over Gasol. The shot's good from Cantor.
Good touch on the jumper, especially from mid-range. Cantor hits a high percentage of those shots.
And we'll just watch the clock wind down, guys, in what will turn out to be a win here for San Antonio.
Looking at both these teams, they're great rebounders, and on any given night, you might not know who would have the advantage on the board.
They made the most of those extra rebounds as well, Kevin.
And so all the hard work here tonight converted into a tally in the win column. It'll be number 26 on the year.
Really, they had their number this season. Two wins, a home win, and an away win.
And what a tremendous standout performance it was for Pau Gasol.
Well, the tone was set by him defensively tonight. Recorded a number of blocks, and that was a big difference maker, intimidating the other team.
Aldridge sets up the pick now for Green. A beautiful reverse.
Timeout.
And saving their best for last. Tremendous run here to seal the win.
And you could just see everything coming together like a perfect storm, and they just rolled on through.
And now let's present our Jordan player of the game, Pau Gasol.
And guys, it's been a rugged brand of defense he's played. I don't know why they keep taking the ball at him. It seems like every time they have, he's come up with the rejection. And with every block, he's only gotten more and more fired up.
He's been their pulse tonight, the player who's guided them to the win. And it's a win they needed coming off a loss in their last one. ...24 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one.
And that's really a function of the offense not working as it should.
Yeah, maybe lazy play calling or just going through the motions on that possession. This often leads to a bad shot.
Now Murray. And so it's San Antonio easily taking this one. This was a very strong showing for him, Greg. Not necessarily a runaway win, but one they'll feel very good about.
And let's face it, anytime you can go on the road and win in the fashion they did, you have to feel good about it. Really an outstanding effort all the way around.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Danny, a strong defensive effort both individually and team. Now, how comfortable are you at that end of the floor now, knowing that you can make things tough on the opposition?
Well, we want to make them take tough shots. We're not comfortable at any point defensively, but we got to continue to be active and be aggressive and get our hands on loose balls.
It's been the mark of the Spurs for a long time, Danny. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Brett Berry, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA, presented by 2K Sports. We'll see you next time.